Hello fellow YouTubers, it's me again, and it's time once again for another Godzilla review. I imagine you guys, you know, are happy about that, you know, my Godzilla fans out there, getting a little sick of Ultron. Well, it's timely fine for the next Godzilla review. This time it's on the 1968 Godzilla. Now, as you know, I got this from Kaiju no More with my giant collection of data or whatever. And so, yeah. This, of course, is from the newest, current, you know, series, the Movie Monster Purple Tag series, as I like to call it. Now, what do I mean by purple tag? Well, I'll show you. Let me get out the tag right here. I have it sitting in my oh-so-awesome card binder thing, which, hell, I'll show you guys. Here we go. Kind of pull it up. See? Yeah, it's like a giant picture of Gomer I found on the internet, and I just colored it. And then inside, keep all the tags and neat little card binder sheets. And I arrange them according to order and stuff. We got Godzilla, Ultraman, and so on and so forth. Yeah. Okay. And here's Godzilla's tag. Here, let me pull this down. Okay, there we go. This thing's a little tricky to use. Here's the tag, Godzilla 1968. The inside shows some stats and a picture of the actual suit. And as you can see, it says on the back, 2006. And like I said, purple tag because it's got the purple border. And as many of you know, it does not have the Godzilla 68 suit. Rather, it has the Godzilla 73 suit from Godzilla vs. Megalon. So, you know, that's a little unusual. I guess Bandai was asleep at the switch or something. Oh well. Now this is, you know, obviously part of their 6-inch figure line. Actually here, let me move this up a little. There we go. This is adjusting the camera tripod. So yeah, part of the 6-inch line. And then I'll show you some comparisons. First of all, I've got over here, I got a few Godzillas. I got, first of all, 1954 Godzilla. As well as 1993 Godzilla. And of course, over here, I got another one of my favorites, 2004 Godzilla. So yeah. These are the majority of the Godzillas I have. I, of course, have the 2000 Godzilla, but it doesn't fit in here with all these guys. So yeah, just kind of showing you their, you know, 6-inch scale. Okay, so let's go to some classic comparisons with other monsters. First of all, I want to show my Showa Gigan. Yeah. There's a good scaling with Gigan. He's more or less the same good size. So yeah, and this is how it was in the movie. The 68 suit versus the 72 suit. So yeah, this is actually a very good pairing. I can get out of here. As many already know, the 68 Godzilla doesn't go good with the 68 Hedorah he was paired with when these two were released. As you can see, he's short. But as you already know from my Bandai Creation Hedorah review, he goes good with what I just said. So yeah. And just to elaborate on that a little, here's the Bandai Creation Godzilla 68. Much different mold and much bigger figure. So yeah, you can see the differences. Obviously these ones have, you know, blue dorsal fins or whatever, and they're smaller and stuff. He's got, you know, he just, you know, looks more like the suit, where this one is more like a cartoonish take on the character. You know, he even has a curved tail as usual, so yeah. Okay. Now, size comparison with classic old King Ghidorah. Move over here. There you go. So yeah, sizing is okay with King Ghidorah. Obviously, you know, it's supposed to be way bigger, but I don't think anyone's going to complain. they are more or less, you know, good scale. You know, I've got to fight King Ghidorah. Okay, that's all I got for size comparisons. You know, I do have other figures I could size them, but that's taking much too much time. Let's go to articulation. First of all, arms can rotate at the shoulder rather than, you know, at the elbow where they move in and out. They move up and down like this. Okay, sorry, phone call. Anywho, where was I? The legs. Yes, the legs. Here's the deal with the legs. They have this little flesh bump here, but there's a reason for that. See this? It goes in here, so it looks like it's actually part of this, like a suit. Look at that. That's brilliant. It makes the, you know, legs look part of the body naturally, but at the same time, it doesn't betray the figure. It looks great, and that's how it should look. You know, the flappy legs, like, obviously if you pull both legs back, it look, you know, you got this weird space in between, and they can't really rotate that well, unless you kind of force it again, but he is, you know, kind of soft vinyl, he's kind of squishy. So yeah, this is definitely a smart move in my opinion. This really helps, you know, the overall look of the figure, make it look like a clumpy suit. And, yeah, it's obviously much better done than, like, say, you know, you would look at the Heisei Godzilla again. Just the way the legs are. You know, like, what an ingenious idea to have the legs like that. Truly ingenious. I commend Bandai for that. And there's also glue to the tail, but if you break it like me, you can turn the tail 360, no problems. Just like that. So yeah, now as for detail, this thing was originally released as part of the 50th Memorial Box. And like all the figures in that Memorial Box set that weren't, you know, reissued figures of other versions or whatever, this thing is incredibly well detailed and extremely accurate to the actual suit. He's got all sorts of little, you know, scales and bumps on his skin. He's got a very nice texture to it. The toes, he's got three toes like it should be. Claws, everything's properly proportioned. That's one thing I really enjoy about the Memorial Box figures, and this one in particular, because obviously, it just resembles the suit so well, right down to the, you know, the neck, the face, the eyes, the tail, and the spines. And that's the thing I like about this paint job, and I'm glad they did this. They obviously, you know, went into more traditional paint job. They took the black charcoal gray vinyl and made some highlights on it. And the blue spines, I love the spines. It came out so well. They're obviously, you know, in blue, but they got little black highlights, and they just look great. And also highlights on the knees and the chest, and here they also got the breastplate or whatever going down the middle. Looks great. But yeah, this Godzilla 1968, while a very common figure and a lot of people have it, there's a good reason for it. It's a good figure, period. Like, I don't care what anyone says, you know, because a lot of people, you know, sometimes I get a little upset when I see people with collections that are nothing but the reissues and Bandai creations. But there's no shame in owning such a good figure like this. It just looks great. It's, again, one of my favorites for sure. I'm so glad I picked this up. Detail is great. You know, especially the face. The face is what seals the deal for me. It just resembles the suit so much, and it's just, yeah. It's not doing right. Whatever. The face just pulls it all together so well. You know, again, the detail and the skin, paint job, it's all great. So yeah, this is the definitive Showa Godzilla figure. Definitely recommend this if you're a fan, and yeah, definitely pick it up. It's very cheap, and it's pretty common and easy to find. So again, I say pick this up. Great figure, you're not going to regret it. I certainly didn't. Whether you pick up the Memorial Box version, which is just green and stuff, or this one, doesn't matter. It's a great mold, and pick up whichever one you want. So yeah, as my review, this thing is an easy 5 out of 5. Good articulation, if you break the glue seal especially. Good paint job, great detail, excellent scaling. This is a great figure overall. Definitely one of my favorites. Among the Final Wars Godzilla, Heisei Godzilla, and 2000 Godzilla, of course. So yeah, that's been my review. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And in the future, hopefully I'll bring you more Godzilla reviews, because I've been getting a lot of Ultraman stuff, and I kind of want to hold off on that for a while, because I just want to start collecting more Godzilla again to fill up my shelves. So yeah, that's my review. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you guys later.